I don't think anyone could have anticipated how popular the first one was. All we knew was that we fell in love with each other. We have so much fun as a cast, and we love the filmmakers. They're incredibly collaborative. I know everyone says that, but this is so true. I mean, Anna, they allowed me to take things from deep inside me that I wanted to say and represent, and that character came out of, you know, me being a 10-year-old girl, never seeing a Disney princess who was as weird as I was. I wanted to be like them, but I didn't have the posture of Sleeping Beauty. I was like, I stand like this. That's not me. Can't we have a Disney princess that, like, talks too much and trips a lot and is, like, super goofy but loves everyone around her? But the thrilling part was just getting everyone back together. We have so much fun making these movies, and I have ultimate trust in our storytellers. So the whole thing is gravy for me. The amount of love that was shown to this movie the first go round was insane, and we realized how important it was for people to see the love of these sisters, for us to take the sort of happily ever after, put it in a blender and throw it across the room and make it about familial love and talk about different types of love. And this next movie, I think, explores some themes that still have yet to have been explored in any animated movie. And it's thrilling to be a part of something that's sort of on the cusp like that.
It's amazing. There's so much work that goes into these films, and everyone that works on it is so immensely talented and such wonderful artists, and are so passionate about it that I know it means so much to be able to finally reveal it to the world and to see that reaction. I mean, it's what these films are all about, you know, joy and bringing people together and magic, and so you can really feel it when you're out there. People that I think were little or young when the first one came out, you know, they've grown up a bit, and I think they've done a great job of, you know, the characters in the films growing up as well. And then this film is very much about, is a coming of age story and finding who you are and stepping into your light and growing up. And so I think it's really going to mirror what a lot of the fans are also feeling. And you know, if anybody can come back with something as good, if not better, then it's Disney, you know, and it's these group of people, and I think it's just going to knock people's socks off.
It's thrilling, really, to return to it. It's been thrilling for the last couple of years that we've been working on it. It's a family that I'm very proud to be welcomed into. It's a character that I love, that teaches me things about myself and my own life. It's song or music that I get to revisit every time I'm on stage doing a concert, and I get to sing it with little kids and big kids. It's been one of the greatest gifts in my career. It feels great because, you know, you're in the studio and it's a more intimate experience, and it's nice to finally unveil it and know that it really spoke to people and had an impact. That's why we do what we do.
This audience, it was off the chain. It was over 6,000 people, I think. And they were obviously very rabid for the Frozen 2. This sort of explosion of sound walking out there was really exciting. I think that the story is so, of the first movie, is so rich and complicated and dense, and the characters are so funny and interesting that when Jen and Chris thought of the new story for the second film, there were so many ways to go and so many ways to deepen it and so many things to explore and find out, which you get to do in the second movie. So we showed like a clip. It was like a 7-minute clip. It was a scene where we're playing charades, and then Elsa hears something calling her, and then she sang an amazing song. And then we sang, yeah, and then after the clip, we came out and sang one of the opening songs from the movie, which is called Some Things Never Change.
Every time we get to share something from this franchise with the greatest crowd on Earth, which is D23, it's such a thrill because we've been holding it so close to the vest for so long. To finally be able to divulge anything is a relief, frankly. And this audience embracing it like they did today was such a thrill. It's so exciting to play a character that is a part of such an amazing catalog of classics And, you know, to have people come up to you on the street and ask for warm hugs, well, sometimes weird, is also something that I'm thrilled I get to experience on a daily basis.